Welcome to my channel World of AWS. I hope you all are doing good. So we are continuing with Terraform tutorial, and we have already seen what is difference between procedural versus declarative method to create resources. Okay, so we have already seen, like, we can use count meta argument and we can write our code this way and we can create resources. Okay, so now we are going to discuss about the another topic, that is creating the resources using declarative method in Terraform. So now at the surface these two approaches may look similar and they will produce similar result. Okay, the interesting thing is what happens when you want to make a change. For example, imagine traffic has gone up and you want to increase the number of server to 15. Okay, with Ansible, the procedural code you wrote earlier is no longer useful. Okay, but if you just updated the number of server to 15 and then reran the code, it would apply 15 new server, giving you 25 total that we don't want. Okay, so using procedural code, we cannot modify. Like, if we want to, if suppose we have run 10 here, right, and we want to like increase it to 15 using procedural code approach. Okay, but we cannot achieve this using this procedural code method. Okay, so we cannot, whenever we are going to write, like apply this procedural code and rerun that code, then like 15 new server will get added. We want how much? 15, right? So how we can achieve it? We can achieve it using Terraform. We can go to our code and we can like modify this count as 15. Okay, and we can just run few command like git terraform init, terraform plan and terraform apply. Okay, so after running terraform apply, 5 new server will get created only. Okay, and the total count of server we will having after running the terraform apply will, that is 15. Okay, so the same thing is like possible using declarative method, but the same thing is not possible using procedural method. Okay, so we can go and we can write our code like this using Ansible. So that is not use case in our scenario, because we want to increase the server count only 5, from 10 to 15. But if we are writing like this and we are running our Ansible configuration again, then it will include 15 new server, right? So with declarative code, since all you do is declare an int state you want, and Terraform figure out how to get to the int state. Terraform will also aware of any state is created in the past using the Terraform state file. If you delete Terraform state file and if you going to run Terraform apply, then all resources going to be created from scratch. Okay, so make sure and make aware, like, you never delete Terraform state file. So therefore, to deploy 5 more server, all you have to do is go back to the same Terraform template and update the count from 10 to 15. Okay, so we are going to update the count of server from 10 to 15 and we have to run the apply, Terraform apply. So after that, running Terraform apply, our server count will have like 15. So 15 server we will having. Okay. So installing Terraform on Windows. Okay. So how we can install Terraform on Windows, we are going to see in the next video. Okay. So if you are new to my channel, then please don't forget to subscribe my channel. And if you have any query, then do let me know in the comment section. And thanks for watching. See you in the next video.